So I came out one day and he was standing there. He said, I can still see him. He scratched his head a little bit. Sister, could I talk to you? I said, sure. I have to bring something across the hall. Just give me a minute, which is what I did. Came back. I said, come on in. I brought him into the inner office. So nobody even saw he was in there.
Yeah.
And
he told you.
I was afraid of what he was going to say because he was one of Father Tom's boys.
Yeah.
So, and unfortunately I was right. Then a couple days later he brought his parents back. And I sat there with the parents. They came after school, so the school was empty. And I sat with them for a while, and they talked to me. And I think I told you this. What broke my heart is when he first told his parents, there was such respect in the church for priests. They didn't believe their own son. And they sent him back to apologize to Tom for accusing him of these vile things. I could have cried on the spot. He told me that before his parents came in, because I encouraged him to talk to his parents. Father Tom immediately took him off all the good serving positions. He punished him instantly for telling his parents what was the truth. Mm-hmm. The only reason that I agreed to respond to you was because my hope is that anyone suffering from abuse in the past, whether it's today, 6 months ago, 45 years ago or longer, please talk to someone. Let the healing begin. And if you're aware of someone who is being abused, go to the authorities immediately.
And is this a question you've asked yourself? Has it shaken your faith at all?
Oh, no, not this. Oh, no. My faith is in God. This is an institutional. It's an institution. Institutions are made up of human beings. And human beings are going to fail. Well, we're not perfect.